where I must say that the 21st century presents us, for the entire humanity, great opportunities to create prosperity, to create a happy society, to create great wealth. And this is going to be created through innovations, through new discoveries. At the same time, we have many challenges of the 21st century, which are at fundamental level. And these challenges are water, these challenges are air, these challenges are the climate, these challenges regards to the biodiversity. So we require discoveries, new discoveries. It is through Mr. Nilesh Neel, who introduced us to the original discoveries of Professor Petrik, Viktor Ivanovich Petrik. And we are very curious. And then we decided that a group of scientists in different fields should come to Russia, come to St. Petersburg, come to Professor Petrik's labs, and really look at these technologies which are not only important to India, but also important to the world. Last 2 days, or the last 3 days now, we have been having presentation from Dr. Petrik and his colleagues. We went to the labs, we saw the experiments, we saw the production units, and we unanimously came to the conclusion that Dr. Petrik is an innovator of the ranks of some of the great innovators of all times, perhaps of the recent times. Particularly of relevance is his works in graphenes and what is called HRCM, high reactivity carbon mixtures, what he calls, and his applications. And one of the applications which was most important to us for a large populated country of the world, 1.22 billion people, is the problem of making available safe drinking water. And it is this technology we examined more deeply. Through the presentation, we feel this is a great promise, and this must be brought to India and to the world. We also feel that if Professor Petrik's innovations are given the support of fundamental sciences, which can be pursued both in India and Russia here, this can be made into great scientific discoveries, scientific innovations. We are going to work, we decided that we are going to work through Water Freedom Revolution, which Nilesh has founded, and this one, and under the umbrella of 21st century, original 21st century discoveries, wherein the Russian scientists and Indian scientists can work together to bring, I think, the technologies to animation, not only for India, but for the world. And we have worked out a program. We have worked out a program by which this can begin right now. This one. There are a lot of, I think, whatever it may be, there are a lot of misunderstandings. There can be every discovery, area of innovation at that age, including what Einstein did, what Tesla did, what Marie Curie did, were questioned at that times. This one. But we are also seeing that situation. But we are going to look at ourselves, examine it critically by the open mind, and take it forward. Because we are keen to solve the problems of the world. Other things are not important to us. We also got acquainted with other discoveries like anti-Stokes compounds. This was known. But bringing anti-Stokes compounds, productionizing these, creating the pilot production of them for, I think, the whole problem the world is facing, the problem of terrorism, the counterfeit notes, counterfeit medicines, counterfeit documents, one can also be, I think, addressed by the innovation of Dr. Petrik, and we want to look at it seriously because we also have a very serious problem of this, that the counterfeit currencies funding the terrorists across the world, and particularly for what against many nations. So we are going to look at that. So there are other issues for us, in particularly our atomic energy program. We have a strong atomic energy program for over the last 60 years, and our colleagues have examined. I will say that on that, and this, and we are also a lot of, I think, the rare earth productions, rare earth in our country, and we want to know how to really extract those rare earths in the form that they become really useful and they can be applied, and they can be applied in a variety of application, including the atomic energy. So we are looking at that program as well. So there is another problem India faces, is the problems of habitat, problems of living for these large populations, and particularly living in the areas of Himalayas, landslides, and I think what we saw recently in the northern parts of India. So we require structures that are safe, they are earthquake proof, they are landslide proof, and we require low cost loss structures of this kind. And it is in this context, the golden formula, which I think which is again rediscovered by Dr.Vijay, and the structures created using that golden formula, or using at least on the basis of that golden formula, which is done by another scientist, that is also relevant to us. So it was, I think there's a great opportunity for me and for us, I think, then when my colleagues, for example, to lead this Indian scientific delegation, consists of the very well-known nuclear scientist, our Dr. Shivaram Bhoje, who has been honored by the Government of India with the highest award, the civilian award, who has been responsible for building our the atomic energy research program in near Chennai, this one, Indira Gandhi National Center for Atomic Energy Research. So, and also a great scientist of, I think, who have built actual power plants. He's a part of our delegation. We have with us Dr. S.S. Pawar, who has one of the highest publications in India in the area of nanosciences and nanotechnologies, and particularly applying this in the field of medicine now, because he's the vice chancellor of a new university, a private university called D.Y. Patil University. We have with us the Dr. Satish Bhatte, who has been, I think, who is an environmentalist, and who leads India's largest laboratory, or the focus laboratory on environmental engineering. It is called National Environmental Engineering Research Institute, NIRI, Nagpur, which is really looking at the problems of pollution here and water pollution this one. And he is also here to examine this. And there are, so, and Mr. Nilesh Neel made this happen. I think we are very thankful to WFR, really, that water freedom revolution is going to be a movement. It is not just an enterprise, it's going to be a social enterprise movement to address these problems. And we are going to try it out. At the end, I would say that Dr. Petrik is a great innovator of the 21st century. I think what we have seen, never before we have seen the scientists that we have the breadth of innovations, breadth of discoveries, which word discovered it first or that, but bringing it to innovation is the challenge. And 21st century, innovations are critical. That is going to create the wealth, that is going to solve the problems of the humanity. So we are extremely happy that we are with St. Petersburg, and we are with Dr. Petrik, and we are simply amazed by his developments. What we feel is that these discoveries, these innovations require also the depth of science in all areas which India can provide. Also the field trials, all the problems of the populations which you can provide on these problems, the field trials and testings and which you can provide and perfect these technologies further and give it to the world. So great opportunity for Indo-Russian scientists. I had an opportunity in the supercomputing program. I led India's supercomputing program, and I must confess that the best help or the best cooperation which you could across the nations, we worked with several nations, was from Russian scientists. So I, once again, I feel that it's a great opportunity, and we love each other, we like each other, we respect both the nations. I think under the framework of Indo-Russian collaborations, what the Government of India and government, I think the Russian government has worked out, called ILTP program and other programs, we can take this forward and create innovations for the 21st century.
Now, please formulate just two sentences concerning personally about the Dr. Petrik.
I said that.
About him.
Only
two. It would be a different section. Oh. Different. Second interview with you. This was okay, all right. And now, about nothing else, only a couple of sentences about this person, because he is a sort of a special event. Yeah. Just think a bit for me. This is personal request which came from Professor Petrik.
I have been in the field of science, research and innovation in the area of computing, information technology and science and technology in general. I've been observing this field. I've been meeting many scientists, many researchers, many innovators of the world across several countries. Meeting Dr.Vijay has been a great honor for me because I regard him one of the outstanding innovators of the 21st century.
Okay. Yeah.